Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are just gonna be hanging out, getting ready together, and playing with a couple new products as well as just old products that I have in my collection. And of course, you know the vibes. We have some drugstore, some high-end, some ColourPop, a little bit of everything. So we're just gonna get ready together and have some girl time. So I hope you guys enjoy, grab a snack, get cozy, and let's get into it. Okay, so first I have a new eye primer. This is in Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Eye Primer. I don't know why it's taken me so long to try this. It's been in my PR stash for a while and I recently started going through all my products and I can finally see the light and see a ton of new things that I've been wanting to test out, and this is one of them. So I actually really like the Hydro Grip primer, like for the face. There are a lot of good dupes for it, but I've actually heard really good things about this eye primer. So we're gonna test it out, and I have a new eyeshadow palette to test out as well. Packaging, this is what it looks like. Love. And let's prime the lids. Oh wow, the formula of this is different. And even when you dip your brush in here, it doesn't even feel like there's a lot of product at all. I'm just gonna use my finger just to blend this in. Feels pretty smooth. You can see it is a colorless primer. It actually feels very, like, not super tacky. Like, it feels like very smooth on the lids. Surprisingly, I thought it was gonna be a little bit more tacky and too dry, but the formula is a lot better than I thought. And today for eyeshadow palette, I have a new ColourPop palette, but you guys already know, they come out with stuff every single second of the day. But this palette looks really, really pretty. It's the Smoke and Roses Pressed Powder Eyeshadow Palette. I love ColourPop's formula. So this is what this palette looks like. It's like a bunch of mauve-y, like pinky tones, super pretty. And I'm gonna start off with this light color up here. This one is in the shade Alone. It's like a very light, muted baby pink. Wow, that actually showed up a lot more than I thought it was going to. Next, I'm gonna go into this shade right here called Angel Eyes. It's like a really pretty, everyday kind of mauve-y pink. And I'm just gonna start working that on the outer lid. I'm gonna do some smoky liner, but the eyeshadow itself, I just wanna keep it really light and pretty and pink. So I'm just popping that shade there, and then I'm gonna add a shimmer and we're gonna do some winged liner and smoke that out. Then I'm gonna take this shade right here called Wild Side. It's like a light shimmery pink. Ooh, it's kind of pink, but it's also kind of rose gold at the same time. I'm gonna put that on the lid. That's pretty. It's really light. I just wanted to see how it would look with my finger, but I'm gonna go in with a brush. Okay, this is actually a little bit more peachy than what I wanted. So I think I'm gonna take this shade down here. It's called Is This Love? It's a little bit more on the purpley mauve side. And I'm gonna just put that on right over top of that other color. The other color's pretty, but it's a little bit too like kind of peachy. And I don't really want like peachy on the eyes or peachy colors on the eyes. I want more like pinky, purpley colors. I'm gonna take a little bit of this color right here on the edge. Kind of just put that on the center as well. I always like to do this. I feel like these colors, a lot of them look the same. Like even when you start blending the shades, like I feel like this palette, it could have been like a smaller palette with maybe less shades, but a lot of the colors in here, they're all super similar. Like if you look at the first two rows up top, like a lot of these even transition colors are so, so similar. I'm not super crazy about the lid shades, honestly. They just look like meh. So let me go into this color up here. It's called Faithfully. This is like a lighter, super light, frosty pink. I'm just layering this up just to lighten this up a little bit. So I'm gonna use gel liner, and I'm actually gonna use this one from Carter Beauty by Marissa Carter. It's just a black gel liner. And I actually have this little brush that I got from the Dollar Tree. It's an e.l.f. angled eyeliner brush. And I'm gonna just use this to do some winged liner. And then I'm gonna take this color right down here. It's like a matte burgundy color, and the shade is This Guy. And with that, ever so lightly, I'm gonna go into a small firm eyeshadow brush. This is just like a pointed blending brush. And I'm gonna take that and just start smudging that out right against that eyeliner. Kinda messed up a little bit right here, but it's okay. We're just gonna keep blending. And I'm gonna clean this up at the end because I still wanna keep that wing there. And just blending and blending. And then you can just kind of clean that up with a makeup wipe. So that's pretty much it. The liner is kind of there as like a guide, and it just helps to give more of that smoky look when you're smudging it out with the eyeshadow. You could do this with any eyeshadow, but I just wanted to add a little bit of that burgundy color because I feel like it complements the other shades really nicely, but it's super simple to do. So I like to add more black liner as I go because it just makes it a little bit more smoky. And then once you start blending it out, it just makes it darker, but totally optional. And that's what's like fun about this look is that you can kind of just play with it as you go and just keep blending and keep adding if you want more. But it's really hard to mess this up because with the gel liner, it doesn't have to be perfect because you're gonna smoke it out anyways. So I went ahead and applied some mascara, and I just used the Milani Anti-Gravity Mascara. And for lashes today, I'm gonna go in with the OMG Synthetic Lashes. And these are in the style So Wispy. So if you guys have never tried OMG Lashes, definitely recommend. I've tried them before. These are Karina's makeup line from OMG Lashes. You guys can go check out her channel. She is so sweet and super talented, and I actually recently saw that she had some new lashes, so I wanted to try them out because I loved the other ones that I've tried from her. So these look so beautiful. Okay, let's put the lashes on. Oh wow, I love these. They're so pretty. They're literally like the perfect wispy lash. They're not too long, they're not too dramatic. Okay, these lashes are everything, and I need like 10 more pairs because they're beautiful. So now for skin, I'm gonna go in with the Milani Make It Last just to prep and prime. I'm gonna cover my eyes just because I just put on the lashes and I don't wanna loosen up any of the lash glue. And I'm gonna use the Hollywood Flawless Filter from Charlotte Tilbury. I have this one in the shade Medium 4. I love this stuff. Like, so good. I love it under makeup specifically. This is like my favorite way to apply it. I think you just get the best result, and it makes your skin look so glowy and beautiful. It's like insane. So I like to blend this out with a foundation brush, and this is the same brush that I'm going to use for foundation later. But look at that glow. It is just so stunning. It's like a healthy inner glow. Like, you know when your friends are like, girl, you're glowing. That's the kind of vibe and effect that you get with this product. Like, it's just stunning. And I also especially like to apply this if I'm ever using maybe a little too much of a matte foundation and I don't want that matte finish. I will use this underneath, and it just like elevates your foundation. So I know this is pricey, but this is definitely, in my opinion, like a good like splurge product because you can use it with any foundation. And I mean, the effect on your skin is just like everything. And I know I'm being extra, but double priming is key. So I'm gonna use the Rare Beauty Pore Diffusing Primer. This is so good, and it actually does fill in your pores. And I'm gonna put this on where I have larger pores just to smooth out that area. So I guess essentially I kind of triple prime because I use primer water and then that Hollywood Flawless Filter from Charlotte Tilbury and then the Pore Diffusing Primer over top. And I know it's extra, but then your makeup is gonna last and look so good and smooth, and you don't have to worry about it. Now for foundation, I'm gonna go in with the Pretty Fresh foundation from ColourPop. I haven't used this in a while, at least I don't remember. And I was looking through my collection and I'm like, okay, I have to use this again. So I have the shade Light 70W, and then I also have Medium 80W. I'm thinking Light 70 because I don't have any color to me right now. I'm gonna use that same foundation brush. This is the Hailey's Beauty Brilliant Kabuki brush. And it is truly one of the best foundation brushes like ever. This is my go-to. It's usually this one and then the e.l.f. Complexion Duo Brush. They're like the ones that I use the most. I like rarely use a beauty sponge anymore for like my foundation just because I love this brush so much. And actually, when you guys are watching this video, Hailey's Beauty is having their 50% off sale for Christmas, so definitely take advantage. You can get this brush. I think it's for like $9 or $10, like super affordable, and it's literally bomb. And this foundation looks really good too. It's really natural and fresh. It's pretty natural, but seriously, I just love the way it looks too with that flawless filter underneath from Charlotte Tilbury. Like, I'm telling you guys, you need that product. So my go-to concealer has been the new NYX Bare With Me Concealer Serum. It is so hydrating and creamy, but I want to switch it up because I've been using it in a lot of my videos recently, and I'm going to do an everyday makeup routine, and that concealer is going to be in there. So I'm going to switch it up today and use the Item Beauty Concealer. This is the Air Hug Concealer, and I have this one in the shade 200. This is really full coverage, so I'm just going to use about that much. And I'm going to use my e.l.f. Camo Concealer Sponge just to blend this out. Less is more with this concealer, as you can see, because it is really full coverage, but if you use too much, it can look a little heavy on the under eyes. I like how seamlessly it blends into the skin. It's really pretty. I can't say it's like my holy grail, like absolute favorite concealer, but the more that I use it, I'm like, okay, this is actually really nice. For like a full coverage concealer, it's not very heavy, but you just need like a little bit. Like even what I used, I feel like can be like too much. Like less is more for sure. Okay, I'm gonna do some cream bronzer and I'm gonna use the contour wand from Charlotte Tilbury. This is so expensive and it needs to come in more shades and I don't understand why it doesn't because the formula is like amazing. Like it blends so seamlessly, but I really love the way this product looks on my skin and like I said, how easily it blends because it can look a little intimidating, but like once you blend it, it's not. It's so good. And I'm just gonna blend this out with my e.l.f. Complexion Duo Brush. Look at that. Love this color too. Like it's just not a dry product. Like it's so creamy. But if you guys have any dupes, please let me know because I'm always down for trying out a good dupe. I think it's more so the formula of this that I love so much because the color I can get with a lot of different cream bronzers and stuff that I have. I mean, I love the color as well, but it's just the formula, it's everything. And then for cream blush, I actually have the Jason Wu Hot Fluff 3-in-1 stick. So I picked these up from Target. So it's basically a lipstick, but you can also use it on your eyes and your cheeks. But this looked really pretty. I got this, like I said, at Target. It was like 20 bucks for 2 lipsticks. And this one is in the shade Jelly Roll. It's like a really pretty kind of like mauve burgundy. It's like a lighter burgundy though. It's very stunning. This is the shade. So I'm just gonna put some like kind of right on the back of my hand. And then from here, I'm gonna use that same brush that I was using. And I'm just gonna apply that to the cheeks. Ooh, that's pretty. Wow. That blended really easily too. Wow, that's really pretty. And I love the idea of being able to use a product on your lips and your cheeks. It's like super convenient and that blended in really nicely and I like the shade. Okay, so I'm just blending out my under eye creases a little bit because, you know, that's inevitable. Everything's gonna crease no matter what, but I try to do little things to like help or whenever I set so that it doesn't look like too creasy. And this is one of those things that I like to do. Just go in right before you're about to set your makeup, take your sponge, blend, and then set immediately after. And you wanna do this before, that way when you go in with your powder, you're not setting your creases. So I'm gonna use the Kimchi Chic Puff Puff Pass Powder. And this one, there's hair on it, my hair. And this one is in the shade Translucent, one of my favorite powders, but I love this powder. It comes in a couple different shades and it's beautiful. Super lightweight, just sets your makeup like effortlessly. I love this too because it's translucent, so if you want to set your entire face with this, you can do that as well. So now I'm gonna add some powder bronzer and powdered blush. I'm gonna use the LYS No Limits Matte Bronzer. This one is in the shade Motivate, which is the lightest color, and I love the formula of this. This has been one of my newer favorite bronzers. It's really nice because it's like warm, but not too warm, not muddy. It's a really smooth formula, and I feel like it just adds like the perfect wash of color. So I really love this brand, actually. They have great products, and I feel like for them being a brand at Sephora, they're not super, super pricey. Like, you know, obviously it's not drugstore price, but it's also not super high end. I would say it's kind of like just medium price point. Then for powder blush, I'm gonna go in with the Blush Aesthetic Palette from Laura Lee Los Angeles. This is everything. Like this blush palette is like my dream. I love the tones in here. I feel like it's perfect with this look as well. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this shade and a little bit of this color, which is Tiger Lily and Caramel Cream. Perfection. I feel like this is like the perfect kind of everyday blush palette or just like a good blush palette to have in your kit if you're a makeup artist. Like the tones in here are beautiful. And just for me using those two shades, like you can see the pigment and just how smooth and effortless that blended into the skin. So I love this. And then there is a highlighter in the blush palette, which looks really pretty. It's kind of like a light golden shade. It looks really nice and like natural, but still bronzy and glowy, which I love. But I have a lighter highlighter here from Palladio that I think I'm going to use instead just because I wanted to test this out. So this is the Palladio Sun-Kissed Highlighter in the shade Sunlight. It's like a light gold. Palladio actually makes my favorite, like all-time favorite blotting sheets. I have them right here, the rice paper blotting sheets. So good. You can get these at Sally's Beauty. I've tried a couple things from Palladio and I really like the brand. I remember when they collabed with Casey Holmes a few years back with their liquid lipsticks and they were some of my favorites. So I think I tried Palladio highlighters before, but we're gonna test this color out today. Doesn't really match with the look, but that's okay. Ooh, that is pretty. It's definitely like a light gold. Ooh, I love how smooth this formula is. Like, how beautiful is this highlighter? It's like not powdery, it's super smooth, but it's like very blinding. So if you're into that, you will love this. The formula of this is just so nice. It's like a wet, intense glow, but like not powdery at all on the skin. Like it's really smooth and creamy. Going back into the lower lashes, I'm gonna just take a little bit of the color That Guy. And this is like that burgundy color that I used to smudge the liner out. And I'm just gonna apply that on the outer part of the lower lashes. I'm actually gonna just bring it in all the way. I'm gonna stop about midway. This is probably my favorite color out of the entire palette. I just love like burgundy tones like this. And then for the waterline and inner corners, I'm gonna use the No Budge Shadow Stick in the shade Rose Quartz from e.l.f. I'm just gonna use this as kind of like a liner. It's like a really light baby pink, so I feel like it's perfect with this look. It's a lot lighter than I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be a little bit more intense. It's not as intense as I thought it would be. And I'm just gonna use the Palladio highlighter in the inner corners. I love how smooth this is. This is a really nice highlighter. I love the tone, the formula. I'm also gonna hit the brow bone with this shade. So I'm gonna use the same lipstick that I used on my cheeks because I love this shade and I feel like it works with what we have going on. But I am gonna line my lips, and I do have these new lip liners from ColourPop. And there's a ton of variety in this little set here, which looks really pretty. Okay, let me try this color out. This one is called Obvi, which is one of my like go-to phrases. It's like shortened for like obviously, you know, Obvi, you get it. Oh wow, it's actually like a nude kind of. It's a little bit darker, but oh no, it's a little bit darker than a traditional nude. Okay. And then I'm gonna top it off with that Jason Wu lipstick. It's a really unique shade, but it's so pretty. It's really comfortable actually. I like the formula of the lipstick. It just like glides on. I am gonna add more blush though, because this blush palette is everything. This color right here is speaking to me. Like it's truly everything. So I'm just gonna set the makeup and then that'll complete this look. Okay, the look is complete. I really love the way this turned out. Like all the tones, I'm feeling it. So there's only really two products in today's video that I wasn't crazy about. And the first one is the e.l.f. No Budge Shadow Stick in the shade Rose Quartz. I think it's maybe just this color because I'm pretty sure I tried these before and they were very pigmented and a little bit more intense. But I thought this was going to be a little bit more kind of vibrant on the waterline, and I didn't really get that wow factor from this. So I did go in with a white liner on the waterline. This is the LA Girl Pastel Dream Auto Eyeliner in the shade of Marshmallow. I did this off camera because I wasn't sure how it was going to turn out, because I typically always use nude versus white because I feel like it's a little bit less harsh. But I really love the way this looks with the tones of the eyeshadow and everything. I just think it really brings everything together and makes it pop. And the only other thing really that I used in today's look that I wasn't too crazy about is the Smoke and Roses eyeshadow palette from ColourPop. And that's just because of the tones in here. Like I feel like this palette, I mean, it's beautiful, but it could have been a smaller palette with less shades, because a lot of these are like almost identical. Like the colors are so similar, which I feel like a lot of eyeshadow palettes, like that's what it is. A lot of the colors are very similar, but a lot of these, especially when you start blending them, they kind of just all morph into one. So this specifically is not my favorite palette from ColourPop personally. I like the look, but I'm just not crazy about the eyeshadow palette itself. Everything else though, I'm in love with. I love the lashes. I love the complexion. I feel like everything just worked hand in hand together beautifully. And I forgot how good this foundation is from ColourPop. The coverage, the finish, it's stunning. This blush palette from Laura Lee Los Angeles is everything. The formula, the pigmentation is so on point. I also really love the fact that you can use the lip color on your eyes, on your cheeks, and your lips as well. So this is really stunning. I feel like this is a good kind of just like wearable wine shade. If you're not into super bold lips, I think you would like this, because it's like, you know, bold, but it's not too much. Like it's totally wearable and it's very comfortable on the lips. So yeah, that is officially it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Check the description box below for all links, and that is it for now. I love you guys. Thanks for being here, and I'll see you very soon in my next video. Bye.